Censorship in digital media goes far beyond liberal versus conservative, or even left versus right. It goes far deeper than simply one group of gatekeepers imposing their ideology onto hundreds of millions of Americans. At a more fundamental level, this is the outworking of cultural Marxism. It's not merely an overheated reaction to the events of the day, like, say, the Capitol Hill riot in January. Instead, it's the implementation of a plan begun decades ago by those who wanted to bring Marxist totalitarianism to the West. If you don't know the name Herbert Marcuse, you would do well to become acquainted with him. Marcuse was one of the German philosophers of the Frankfurt School, who emigrated to Columbia University here in America during the rise of the Third Reich. They rechanneled Marxism into what became known as critical theory, which lives on today as critical race theory and gender theory and so on. It seeks to destroy capitalism by overthrowing cultural norms in the revolutionary pursuit of a supposedly more just society. Among the cultural norms Marcuse was dedicated to overthrowing was free speech, an American value enshrined in our First Amendment. Marcuse said that people who are considered among the powerful, which in critical race theory is thought to be especially white, straight males, need to have their free speech severely curtailed. He called tolerating all viewpoints repressive tolerance, and instead called for liberating tolerance. In his words, liberating tolerance then would mean intolerance against movements from the right and toleration of movements from the left. In other words, ideological censorship. How do Twitter and Facebook get away with banning the President of the United States? How is it possible that Amazon and Apple could act together to destroy alternative social media platforms? When you understand the history, it's no surprise at all. Just look to Herbert Marcuse's call for the kind of heavy-handed censorship now being imposed on our nation by cultural elites steeped in Marxist critical theory.